there, scientists! It's Justin again. Today, we are filming at a garden to get a closer look at flowers. They have so many different kinds of flowers growing here. The flowers are all different colors, shapes, smells, and there are a ton of bees. Hummingbirds, butterflies, and other insects are hanging around here too. Why do you think these flowers all look so unique? And how do they attract all of these creatures? Let's take a deep dive into these flowers to learn more about them and what their role is in the environment. Mia, can we zoom in on the inside of a flower to see how it works? What do you notice when we open up this flower? The petals stand out to me. Those are the brightly colored outer parts of the flower. Then we have these long stalks that are covered in some yellow powdery stuff. What do you think they could be? Oh, sorry, excuse me. It's pollen. We have allergy seasons because lots of flowers tend to start opening their petals and releasing their pollen into the air during the spring and summer months. There are two main parts inside of the flower. One is the stamen, where the pollen is created and released. You can see this flower has four stamens that surround the other part of the flower, which is called the pistil. This is the part of the flower where pollen is caught. Wait, so flowers are creating pollen and catching it? How do you think they catch pollen? Are they getting it from other flowers or what? Ooh, Mia, zoom in on this bee's legs. Well, that stuff looks familiar. It's pollen. Oh, these bees must be pollinators. Pollinators are animals and insects that move pollen between flowers. Let's follow along with this pollinator to learn more about how and why it's moving pollen. Bees collect flower pollen and nectar for food. The bee takes what it can and then moves on to another flower. The pollen is sticky, so the bee will be covered in it and transfer the extra pollen to the next flower it visits. The pistil on the new flower catches the pollen from the bee, and the pollen then travels down to a part of the pistil called the ovary. This whole process is called pollination. So, now that the flower is pollinated, what does that mean? Why do you think flowers go through all this work to get pollen? Take a moment to pause the video and make a prediction in your field notes. After the flower is pollinated, it will mature and form seeds. Let's check out two different flowers that were pollinated a while ago and see how they've changed. What are all these things inside of these poppy flowers where the bright red petals used to be? Tons and tons of seeds. These will fall out or be collected to plant and grow new flowers. And the yellow flowers on this tomato plant are starting to form tomatoes. We can't see these seeds because they're inside the fruit. All fruits start out as flowers first. So, what are flowers? They're the part of many plants that help the plant reproduce, or make more of itself. And to reproduce, these flowers rely on pollinators. We've seen how bees pollinate flowers and help carry on their life cycles, but bees are not the only kind of pollinator. Pause the video and record three other animals or insects you've noticed visiting flowers in your field notes. While you were thinking, Mia was collecting footage of a bunch of other pollinators. She found moths, flies, butterflies, hummingbirds, beetles, and even bats. What do you think keeps these pollinators from pollinating the same flower over and over? Why don't they all just visit giant sunflowers or bright red roses? Well, different pollinators are attracted to their own favorite colors and scents during different times of the day. So flowers develop ways to draw in their ideal pollinator. What kinds of flowers does it look like these bees are attracted to? These lavender flowers give off the scent of sweet nectar that bees love to eat. Bees look for blue and purple, as well as yellow and ultraviolet colors that we humans can't see. What do you notice about the milkweed flower this monarch butterfly is drinking from? Butterflies look for red, orange, or purple colors and need a sturdy platform for their delicate bodies to perch on while they drink nectar with their long tongues. Flies are a little less concerned about beauty and are more attracted to, rotten smells. The flowers they find might smell less sweet and more like food or garbage. Moths and bats are nocturnal. So how do you think flowers attract pollinators at night? The petals of this primrose open as the sun goes down. So when other pollinators are turning in for the night, moths have these flowers all to themselves. So now you can see why all these flowers look and smell so unique. They need to appeal to the perfect pollinator who can assist them in the pollination process. But what is the purpose of having a flower garden like this one? The flowers are nice to look at, sure, but is there something more to it? Mia, where did that bee go after we saw it pollinating the lavender plant? Oh, Mia followed the bee back to the community garden. Here it is visiting a zucchini flower. And after that, the bee found the apple tree. Because of this bee's help, the flowers on both of these plants will be able to form zucchinis and apples that we can eat. Oh, then Mia followed the bee all the way to its hive where it's bringing all of the pollen it's collected. Bees also make use of flower pollen to produce honey. Their honey has major health benefits for the humans that consume it, such as reducing allergy symptoms and boosting our immune systems. So having a flower garden like this one can attract all different kinds of pollinators and lead them to fruit and vegetable plants. Many of the foods we eat would not be possible without flowers and pollinators. It seems to me like flowers are pretty good things to have around. Today, we've learned the parts of a flower and how those parts help plants to reproduce. That pollination is the process of pollen moving through the parts of the flower in order to form fruit and seeds, and that pollinators help flowers in the pollination process. I think these bees are good to have buzzing around too. Thanks for helping us film today. Remember, the wildest discoveries are yet to come. Until our next journey, science explorers. Hey, hey.